Hey there, it's Ted from Wrike here. In the next couple of minutes, I will show you how to use Wrike as a contributor. So, you've just signed a contract with your client to work on the design of a pet shop. Awesome! Your client uses Wrike to manage their work, and they mentioned they will share a project with you. Not sure what this means? No need to worry, we are here to help. Let's take a look and see how we can bring collaboration to the next level together. Luna looks interested to learn more too. First, check your email for an invitation to Wrike. Here it is. Click Accept Invite and create an account to join the team. Just enter your name, create a strong password, then select department and job title. Let's get started. You are now in the Wrike workspace, and there is a notification in your Wrike inbox that Sharon shared a Happy Paws design project with you. Let's learn more about the project by clicking Open Default View. First thing to do when you open your project is to pin it so you can quickly access it at any moment. Just click this pin icon and your project will appear under the pinned section of the menu. You can access more helpful task management tools from the sidebar, such as My To-Do, Starred Tasks, Calendars, Stream, and others. Customize the menu to only see what's most relevant to you. If you need to find a certain task, use the search box. It also lets you quickly access recently visited tasks, projects, and folders. It's important to note that as a contributor, you only get access to items shared with you, whether they're spaces, folders, projects, or tasks. Whenever an item is shared with you, but you're not part of the parent location, such as a space or folder, you can find that item under the Shared With Me section. Before we move forward, I just want to take a moment and show you how the work in Wrike Workspace is organized. It's great that Sharon has just added you to the team space too. Spaces are centralized repositories that help organize the folders and projects the team uses. Folders serve as buckets to house related projects and tasks. Projects are initiatives containing related tasks dedicated to a single goal. Tasks are the main actionable units in Wrike. Let's take a look at one of the tasks assigned to you in the project. And by the way, you can always collapse the sidebar, as well as open the task full screen to focus only on the details you need at the moment. In the Design Display Stands task, you can see important details such as due date and description. Once you start working on the task, choose the required status from the list. This way, Sharon and the other team members involved will stay up to date on the work progress. As you begin designing the stands, tracking your time might be crucial for accurately reporting hours, managing your workload efficiently, and ensuring precise invoicing for billable hours. Wrike's time tracking feature makes this straightforward. Open the task and click the play button to start the timer, which records your hours and minutes precisely. You can navigate around Wrike without losing track of your timer. If you need a break or switch tasks, pause the timer with a click, and resume any time by pressing play again. Click the timer to add comments about what you managed to work on and add a category to the time taken. This will allow Sharon to know how you have been utilizing your time. It's important to mention that your contributor license gives you limited access to Wrike's editing features. You can't create new tasks or edit existing task details, but you can collaborate on the tasks or items that are shared with you. For example, you can change tasks and projects' start and due dates as needed. You can attach files from your computer or online storage services and leave comments with at mentions to loop specific team members into the discussion. As you progress with the project, you might want to apply different filters to your task list, or sort it in a particular order convenient to you. Let's see how you can easily do it in Wrike's table view. By default, your tasks are filtered by all active status. If you'd like to see all tasks, including those completed or deferred, you can switch the filter to all tasks. You can also apply other filters. For example, you only want to see high priority tasks. Just click More Filters and choose High under the Importance filter. Now you know which tasks Sharon wants you to prioritize. To clear all filters applied, click Clear Filters here. In addition to filters, you can sort your tasks by their status, priority, or other parameters, or group them by system fields like status, due date, assignee, or start date. Table view is great to see all the necessary task details at once. You can add or remove certain column fields and track your tasks in the way that works best for you. Depending on the project settings enabled by the project owner, you may see additional views to help you monitor your work. Board view allows you to see task progression by status. Gantt chart gives you a bird's eye view of the project plan with all its dependencies and milestones. Chart view is a visual and user-friendly analytical solution, and calendar view displays your work items on a timeline to keep track of what needs to be worked on and when. To further maximize collaboration, you can view dashboards shared with you. Dashboards provide a comprehensive overview of task statuses and progress. A cool thing about dashboards is that you can interact with widgets and perform tasks directly from them. Switching between the big picture and specific details has never been easier. Benefit from real-time updates to always have the latest data at your fingertips. Your dashboard refreshes automatically as project information changes. Riley just wrote you back. She likes the design, but has made a few adjustments. She has asked you to approve the new changes before sending it to Sharon for approval. Add a smiley face reaction to her message to indicate that we've seen it. You take a look at Riley's changes and think it's an excellent adjustment. It's now time for Sharon to take a look. You change the task status to in review and start an approval process for Sharon. Submitting a task for approval is easy. Just click the approval button here, then select the approver, due date, attach the necessary file, and click start. Done. As you send the task for approval to Sharon, she will automatically receive a notification in her Wrike inbox. Please note, the approval feature is available on Business Plus and higher Wrike plans only. Sharon says,
"This looks amazing,"
and approves the task. It looks like you and Luna are rocking this project, and Wrike tools help you take control of your work and never miss a detail. If you'd like to further explore Wrike and try its other features, create your own Wrike account for free from the Account Management panel. That's it for today. Have a productive day.